Power star Pawan Kalyan has been Tollywood's loose cannon hero since 96 and an equally unpredictable politician since 2014. He's currently on a recruitment spree and has been roping in bureaucrats from the most unexpected places into his Janasena party. His singular antics worked on the silver screen. But is he really set to become the new savior of the Telugus of the Andhra Pradesh this year? And how well does he play the game? Grab your popcorn and add some Rayalaseema red chili. Despite being Chiranjeevi's younger brother, he refused to pander to the megastar's audience and set a trend all of his own. There have been a number of entrants from the Konidela family into Telugu cinema, all quite successful. But Pawan Kalyan still looms large and all alone. Right from 1996, in which he debuted in the film Akkada Ammai Ikkada Abbai, he's only acted in one film per year, or at the most, two. This is something that actors dare to do after they turn into bankable superstars. 2014's Attar Inti Ki Daredi was the biggest grosser of all time in Telugu cinema until Bahubali broke reality. And that was the year he entered politics and called his party Janasena. Pawan Kalyan was the most searched celebrity politician on Google that year. He wasn't the white shirt, white dhoti Babu who bends in humble namaste to the audience. In 2014, at the launch of Ism, a book he wrote on his ideology and that of his party Janasena in Vizag, he spoke about how he didn't come for votes or political power or high position, but because his gut burned. And then he waved like a film celebrity. See, I have my opinions about who's a better actor between Chiranjeevi and Pawan Kalyan, but unscripted, Pawan Kalyan is boss. He's got clear diction that flits between casual Vizag slang, Hyderabadi overtones and explosive poetry in chaste Telugu. He's a born public speaker. His only goal when he launched Janasena was to eliminate the Congress party from the state. In 2009, the INC coalition won 34 out of 42 seats. And 33 of these belong to the INC. As star campaigner for Chandrababu Naidu's TDP, Pawan Kalyan effectively routed the Congress. But this is Andhra Pradesh and one doesn't do politics on the basis of ideologies. Here, politics is all about caste. Speaking purely on the basis of numbers, TDP won because the Kapu caste, who formed 15% of the electorate, voted for Chandrababu Naidu and against Congress. And this is why Pawan Kalyan could be a game changer for 2019. The Kapu votes will decide the government this year, since they're a homogenous group who typically vote all in for one chosen candidate. Despite Jagan Mohan Reddy's 3,600 km padayatra, despite Chandrababu Naidu's 5% reservation bill to the Kapus, Pawan Kalyan is yet again the dark horse who is capable of drawing the Kapu votes all to himself. He is one of them and has two decades of cinema and its enduring fandom in his favour. His political decisions have never been flamboyant. He's already managed to rope in big names who will strategize his campaign blitzkrieg further. Whether Pawan Kalyan stands a chance at becoming CM this year is debatable, but he's definitely a force to reckon with. I don't know about his party's campaign song, but this one from his 2018 dud Agyatavasi is surely apt for the situation. Kodaka Koteswar Rao Karusai Potauro పులసలాగా ఎగిరి పడితే పులుసైపోతావురో చిరిగిన పరుసైపోతావురో చెయ్యి పడితే మాడిపోయిన అరుసైపోతావురో కొడక సోదరా సోదరీమణులు అందరూ మరొక్కసారి ఇంత కంటెంతో